Shadow Cursed, The Shadow Accords, Volume 2. Written by D.K. Holmberg. Narrated by Emily Sutton-Smith. Chapter 1. The palace walls no longer towered over her as they once had, but Carth still felt the pressure from them, something that was more spiritual than actually physical, yet left her wanting to escape, nonetheless. The creeping ivy along the side felt like her spirit clamoring to get free of the palace, with the incessant training and the brutality she faced each day. "If you keep staring at that wall, you're bound to find some fault in it, don't you think?" Carth glanced to Samus, who lounged near the wall, his sword resting across his legs, a sheen of sweat coating his brow. How long had he been sitting there watching her? Probably too long, she decided. Long enough to know how she longed to leave the practice yard, and how she longed to climb like the ivy and see the inside of the city. It had been 5 years since she'd been allowed out. 5 years she had remained within these walls, not imprisoned so much as protected. "What's to find fault with?" she asked. She made a conscious effort to tear her hand away from the hilt of her sword and turned to face him. Though the top of her head might only come to his shoulders, she wasn't about to let him see her intimidated, mostly because she wasn't, not really, but also because she had to struggle for every bit of respect she'd gained while training, and she wasn't about to let Samus Gold take any of it from her. "The ivy is beautiful as it grows along the sides of the walls." Samus stood and wiped the edge of his blade with his shirt. What was the fool doing with his shirt off anyway? If he thought that impressed her, then he was mistaken. Well, mostly mistaken. "Who cares if the ivy is beautiful? Look at the stone. That's where the strength is. The ivy doesn't keep you from getting past the wall, does it? That's the stone."
"I would suggest that you are both wrong."
Carth jerked her head around to see Invar Tolnason standing behind them. How had he managed to sneak up on her so easily? All this time, she'd been thinking she was getting more skilled, but with one simple act, he made it clear just how little she had learned. She would use the shadows to determine where he was, but the shadow magic had been forbidden from her here. Not because the Arras thought she shouldn't use it, but because these walls somehow blocked her from doing so. It was for her own good, John had told her before leaving her here. Because of it, she would learn the Arras way. And from there, she could develop other abilities and eventually merge them with her ability with the shadows. But Carth couldn't help but feel that she was missing something, because she hadn't used it for so long. She refused to let herself think about whether she could still even reach the shadows when she crossed to the other side of the wall.
"How is that wrong, Master?" Samus asked. He flipped his shirt over his shoulder as he sheathed his sword. She would have rather seen him cover himself than the sword. At least the sword she could deal with.
"Your assumption is wrong. You believe that it must be either the stone or the ivy."
"You think it's both?" Samus asked.
Invar arched a brow at Samus's casual tone. If Samus was going to attempt such a relaxed attitude with any of the masters, it should not be Invar. Carth wasn't even surprised to see him. Invar had been appearing around her more and more often, which she thought was strange, but there was nothing she dared say about it, not to one of the masters.
"I think that there could not be strength without the other. The ivy needs the stone for support, and the stone needs the ivy for its beauty."
"Yes," Invar said, tipping his head to Samus.
"Beauty. There is strength in beauty."
Samus touched the leaves of the ivy and plucked one from the vine. He brought it to his nose and sniffed it before tossing it back to the ground.
"Yet it is neither the ivy nor the stone which grants the strength that you discuss."
"What then?" Samus asked.
"You study with the Arras, yet you must question what gives strength to the wall."
Invar stared at them intently for a moment. Power radiated from him, as if the man exuded it. With Invar, that was possible. He turned his back to them and left, crossing the lawn at a measured pace, his hands clasped behind his back. Samus grabbed a strand of ivy and jerked. The muscles in his arm flexed, giving him another chance to show off, but the vines didn't budge. Some of the leaves fell, but there was nothing else he could do to tear them free, short of unsheathing his sword again and hacking at them.
"You don't care for the beauty?" she asked.
Samus sniffed. "Beauty? These are weeds, Carth, regardless of what Invar claims. They don't do anything to hold the wall. What Invar doesn't say is that it's the Aris magic that does it, not vines or stone." Carth couldn't feel the magic in the walls, but that didn't mean it wasn't there. Just because she couldn't feel the shadows didn't mean that they weren't there either. She might not be able to use that magic right now, but she knew it existed. And one day, when she was finally free after her time with the Aris, she'd be free to reach the shadows again. Samus jerked his shirt from his shoulder and swung it around. He flashed a wide smile and nodded after Invar. "I think he intends to claim you." Carth shook her head.
"I don't think he claims any students these days." It would be a great honor were Invar to choose her for studies, but it had been years since Invar was said to have taken a student. She doubted he had any interest, and even if he did, she doubted he would choose her.
Samus shrugged. "Maybe he hasn't, but I've seen the way he watches you, like you're a puzzle he can't quite figure out. What better way to work through a puzzle than to bring it closer, so that it has no choice but to spend time with you?"
Carth shot him a hard look, but Samus completely ignored it.
"Now, I thought we were supposed to practice here. That was the entire reason I came out to this part of the yard," he said.
"You suggested here because you don't want the others to see me defeat you."
Samus's grin faded. "You won't defeat me.
Like I did Wulden yesterday?"
"That was luck, Rel, and you know it."
She unsheathed the knife at her belt and twisted it in her hand. As she did, she reached for the connection to the Aris magic, that source deep within her. In the 5 years she'd been confined within the palace yard, she had spent most of that time trying to master the technique required to simply access the magic. That was the hardest part of truly becoming one of the Aris. Reaching that power, that source of magic that the Aris had first believed lay within her, required pulling from a connection that flowed through her veins. She could feel it, the same way she felt it when others used their magic. Once she managed to master reaching the magic, then she could learn ways of connecting to that power and using it for other purposes. The knife helped her hone her connection to the magic, to focus it. Someday she hoped she would no longer need the knife as a focus, even though many of the Aris never reached that point. The masters, however, had, and were able to focus their magic without need of an object. She still couldn't reach that power nearly as quickly as she would like. It came, but it was something like pulling molasses through her veins, trying to separate from her blood, and doing so was painful. That was another part of the lessons she'd had to learn, finding a way to reach that power in spite of the pain. None of the others studying here experienced the same pain. Carth remembered how much it had hurt when she'd first reached the power flowing through her, like her blood had boiled or had grown too thick for her veins. The masters had frowned when she'd described what she felt, and she remembered all too well how Master Harrison had claimed that any pain was mental rather than physical. Carth found it strange that she still hadn't managed to get past the psychological pain after all these years of studying. When she'd lived near the docks, using the shadows had required none of the same focus or pain as pulling on Aris magic. She wanted the same ease that she remembered, and even tried to reach for. But the shadows remained blocked to her, possibly by the Aris magic infused in the walls she and Samus had just been discussing. Her skin tingled, telling her that Samus had reached his magic. He used a short sword. The Ushai were not allowed longer or more complex weapons until they were able to craft them on their own, and sent the magic surging into it. Carth's own focus reached her power only a second or two behind him.
but too slowly. He lunged, swinging his sword slicing toward her. Carth ducked, rolling toward the ground, thrusting the long-bladed knife out in front of her, catching his sword and deflecting.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.